Ouchterlony Double Diffusion for Antigen-Antibody Patterns. Objective: to illustrate antigen-antibody interaction and learn the technique of Ouchterlony Double Diffusion. The key reaction of immunology and immune defense is interaction of antibodies and antigens. The specificity of antigen-antibody interactions has led to the development of a variety of immunology assays which can be used to detect the presence of either antibody or antigen. In Ouchterlony Double Diffusion, both antigen and antibody are allowed to diffuse into the gel. Antigens from different species are loaded into two wells, and the known antibody is loaded in a third well located between and slightly below the antigen wells to form a triangle. Depending on the similarity between the antigens, different geometrical patterns are produced between the antigen and antiserum wells. The patterns of lines that form can be interpreted to determine whether the antigens are same or different. Materials required: agarose, 1x assay buffer, antiserum, test antigens, glass slide, gel punch with syringe, template, incubator, conical flask, measuring cylinder, alcohol, distilled water, micropipette and pipette tip, petri plate, cotton. Procedure: prepare 15 ml of 1.2% agarose in 1x assay buffer by boiling to dissolve the agarose completely. Cool the solution to 55 to 60 degrees Celsius. Wipe the glass slide with alcohol to make it grease-free for even spreading of agarose. Pour 4 ml onto the glass slide placed on a horizontal surface. Allow the gel to set for 30 minutes. Punch wells by keeping the glass plate on the template. Label the wells on the opposite side of the glass slide. Fill the lower well with 10 microliter of antiserum and the upper two wells with 10 microliter each of antigen 1 and 2. Keep the glass plate in a moist chamber overnight at 37 degrees Celsius. After incubation, observe for opaque precipitation lines between the antigen and antiserum wells. Results: pattern of identity A. In this pattern, the antibodies in the antiserum react with both the antigens, resulting in a smooth line of precipitate. The antibodies cannot distinguish between the two antigens, that is, the two antigens are immunologically identical. Pattern of partial identity B. In this pattern of partial identity, the antibodies in the antiserum react more with one of the antigens than the other. The spur is thought to result from the determinants present in one antigen but lacking in the other antigen. Pattern of known identity C. In the pattern of known identity, none of the antibodies in the antiserum react with antigenic determinants that may be present in both the antigens. That is, the two antigens are immunologically unrelated as far as that antiserum is concerned.